So now what we want to do is show you how to tune a servo motor with the Drive Manager 2 and the Beckhoff AX8000 drive. The motion control is very smooth and but very, very lax. Now in the application, you have to get a little bit quicker. And with that, there may have been a misjudgment in the actual sizing of the application. And we've maybe didn't get the right metal for this product, or maybe there's something else. And so what we found out now when we hook up the mechanics in the system is that we're working with a 27:1 inertia mismatch. So instead of trying to rework the motor, put a new motor in that's better suited for that type of control, let's see if we can tune out this inertia. When we start running the application, you're going to see some basic position lag that occurs. And when you run it a little bit quicker, you're going to see a little bit higher position lag. And what you'll see here is about 40 degrees of lag distance in the set point generation. So here you can see the basic motion. We have pretty low lag, but it is about 4 degrees plus or minus in the application. Here, when we go back in and we jog it, we'll start the motion. And now with the new dynamics in the application, we're seeing a lot of oscillation, almost 40 degrees of oscillation plus or minus. You can adjust the velocity in the position controller right here in Drive Manager 2. You can adjust the interval gain. You can also add position control. And with your tuning the system, you can see you're getting a little bit over oscillation in the system. So your effort, you're causing a lot of oscillation in the application. Let's stop the motion control. Go to the Drive Manager Tune Drive section. Go to Auto Tuning. And here, you can start seeing the Auto Tuning interface. The very first step we're going to do is add a dynamic container. And we're going to set it for oversampling. We're going to enable the Bode plot and the oversampling for the NC by these two checkboxes. We're going to go to the AX8000 access module. We're going to go into the advanced section. We're going to go to the slot settings, and we're going to bring in bi-quad filters in case we need them after running auto-tuning. We're going to apply two of them because our mechanics are very, very simple, so we shouldn't need any complex bi-quad control. After the system is reactivated, we can go back to the motion control side of things. We can get it moving the way that we wanted to. The axis is up and running now. Go back to the run motor section, run the motor, kind of see where we were before. Okay. So we can see that we have about 1 degree to the faster acceleration. And now with that, we see almost 6 degrees of position lag. So to improve this, what we can do is we can stop the axis, go to the tune drive section. It's telling us that we're not ready yet. So let's go back to the run motor section. Let's enable the motor. In the auto tuning features, what you have is it will tell you, give you hints of how to improve the tuning of the axis. Here you have different conditions. You can hit change your stability conditions as well. For the Bode plot side of things, you have two sections. You have the frequency steps and the max steps per response. You have a multi-sinus, which really speeds up the oversampling of the system. And here we'll start the auto-tuning. So when you execute the auto-tuning, what you're going to see is you're going to start seeing oscillation in the motor. With this, we have the Bode plot results of what the performance is of the application. Once the auto-tune has seen the Bode plot results, It runs the algorithm. So the next step in auto-tuning is actually starting the auto-tuning process. Note that when you execute the auto-tuning feature, the axis is going to oscillate. So you're going to see motion in the axis. This is going to give us the oscillation that we need to analyze the data. Take care when you execute the auto-tuning because the motion is going to happen on the axis. So what you're seeing now is the results of the oscillation back into the Bode plot diagram. So this is what we're going to use for the algorithm. And then once the algorithm gets results, it's going to reapply the parameters that it figured out, rerun the oscillation, and do a compare and give you the results. The black results are the initial results of the tuning effort, and then the red chart is the results in which we think will improve the tuning. Once it finishes execution, you'll see a successful execution. We can go back, run the motor. We can see the oscillation or the position lag. Go back to auto-tuning. We can commit to those changes, and we can download those. And now you see we're able to hold a position accuracy very, very tightly and less than 1 degree plus or minus. There are further features that are built in. We can actually go with the inertia of the system now. You can see the 27:1 inertia ratio. So we know the inertia. So now the velocity observer is configured. Here you can go to the position controller and add feed forward control. And now we have motion control down to 0.05 degrees of accuracy. So right there, you can see how simple it is to run through the auto-tuning, the three required steps to get auto-tuning started. You can see utilizing this tool, running through the exercise of auto-tuning will give you very precise motion control for your application. This has always been something we've been able to accomplish. The velocity observer is one feature that we used. And with that, we had our advanced tuning, which helped us configure the velocity observer. Sense the inertia, helped us set up the bandwidth around the velocity observer. The Bode plot was used a lot with complex mechanics. And what this is now that we call auto-tuning is an integration of both those software packages into one. This really assures that you can perform well with very, very easy tools to tune an axis. And with the special care that you may need to take with auto-tuning, just be aware of what you're trying to move. You can accomplish precise motion control by just clicking through the auto-tuning software. And because of the configuration that is needed, you're guided through with the diagnostic messages that are part of it. Thank you again for your time. And let us know if you have any questions and need support tuning an axis.